Hello, and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Paul.
And I'm Manu.
And in this video, we will talk about Power BI licensing. There are two main parts to Power BI, Power BI Desktop and the Power BI Service. Power BI Desktop is a free tool that lets you ingest and transform data, build data models, and create reports. The Power BI Desktop file can be saved and published to the Power BI Service and then shared with others. To consume content published to the Power BI service, you need to be licensed either by having a Power BI Pro license or by consuming content published onto a Power BI Premium capacity. A Power BI Pro license is required for those users publishing reports, sharing content, and collaborating with colleagues in workspaces. Power BI Premium provides a dedicated resource for running reports and dashboards in the Power BI service for your organization or your team, giving you dependable performance and larger data volumes. Content can also be embedded into SharePoint, Teams, or a custom application using Power BI Premium or Power BI Embedded. Please see links below in the description for more details on all of these options. Power BI Premium is licensed by capacity, with dedicated resources from Microsoft made available in the cloud as part of the Power BI service for an organization's exclusive use. This dedicated capacity can be applied to a specific set of users against an intensive workload or for other scenarios requiring heightened performance. Power BI Premium also enables organizations to extend BI access to a broad set of users without the need to purchase individual seats for them. With Power BI Premium, Power BI Pro users are able to distribute dashboards, reports, and other content within and outside the organization. Power BI Premium also enables you to embed content in other applications, create larger data models, and incrementally refresh your model. You can also create paginated reports, which are based on the report definition language in SQL Server reporting services. Premium also includes Power BI Report Server, which is an on-premises version of Power BI with a web portal. You can build your BI environments on-premises and distribute reports behind your organization's firewall. There are multiple ways to purchase a Power BI Pro license. For individuals that have been assigned an Office 365 E5 license, a Power BI Pro license is included in the cost. For users with an E1 or E3, Power BI Pro can be purchased as an add-on. You can purchase a Power BI Premium Capacity node through the Office 365 Admin Center and can have any combination of Premium Capacity SKUs within your organization. Power BI Premium includes Power BI Report Server, and customers with SQL Server Enterprise Software Assurance also have access to Power BI Report Server as part of the Software Assurance benefit. In this scenario, a firm has 10,000 employees across multiple divisions. Each division has their own BI goals and associated licensing requirements to achieve those goals. A finance team is actively working to analyze several large data sets in advance of an earnings announcement and requires unthrottled and isolated capacity to manage the workloads. Because the finance division has all of their 5,000 employees covered with Office 365 E5, they do not need to purchase standalone Power BI Pro licenses. With Power BI Premium, they can customize capacity based on their unique needs, and they can purchase their own dedicated capacity and control the users, the content they serve, and their SLAs. The HR division has already purchased Power BI Pro standalone licenses for many of their users and wants to extend read access to reports throughout the organization. The HR division purchases Power BI Premium to extend read access to reports and dashboards across their organization. Power BI Premium includes Power BI Report Server, extending hybrid capabilities, including on-premises report publishing. This way, the HR team can deploy and distribute interactive Power BI reports completely within the boundaries of their firewall. The rest of the company does not have the requirement for any of their employees to create or publish BI at the moment. No additional licenses are required for the rest of the company, and reading of published BI is covered in the existing Power BI Premium purchases by the HR and the finance divisions. What Power BI licenses do you currently have in your organization? We would recommend documenting your current licensing, but also to review the usage patterns for Power BI in your organization that were documented previously. You can then review what licenses you will need to meet these requirements. Do you have or are you looking at purchasing Power BI Premium? Based on the discussion in the previous slide, are there reports with a larger number of consumers? Do you need larger data models? Or are you looking to benefit from some of the additional functionality offered by Power BI Premium?
This and the next few slides show some sample license assignment approaches. For small organizations or organizations with a strong governance and control, Power BI Pro license assignment for all users may be the way to go. And this can be done with PowerShell to avoid a lot of manual work. For most large customers, there's a need to ensure that tool-specific guidance is in place. So this is another potential workflow for license assignment, where everyone needs to watch a usage guideline video that covers key governance considerations and organizational best practices. The license can be programmatically assigned to the user once they've watched the video. Some customers believe that content authors should be made aware of the usage guidelines, and consumers of the content can potentially be assigned licenses as soon as they're added to an Office 365 group or an app workspace that hosts a Power BI solution. An optional introductory video can be made available to those who are interested in getting familiar with the technology. This can even be a link to a Microsoft training video on YouTube. Power BI Premium could enable another workflow where free licenses are assigned to everyone, so that anyone can consume content from premium workspaces as and when it's available. The Pro license assignment workflow for the authors can remain unchanged in this scenario. License assignment is one of the most important parts of your strategy. And now that we've discussed a few options, at this point, you should have a discussion about how you will go about assigning Power BI licenses. The three key options are, you could either assign licenses to all users at the time of release, or you can have a phased rollout where you assign licenses to all users over time. Alternatively, you can follow an approach where you're signing licenses on request. It's important to discuss the approval process as well. We have included a link to the slides that we've used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment below. See you in the next one.